In this video, we are going to learn how to use the extensions menu in Inkscape to apply patterns of complex composite shapes along a predefined path. This tutorial will set the stage for us to know how to use these techniques and those learned from previous videos on this series for illustrating complex things with repetitive patterns. I began the series with the simple skills and add more complex ones each new video. So I invite you to watch the previous videos on this playlist if you have not yet done so. I have a link in the description section below for you. For here, we will begin seeing how to illustrate parts of something like a vesicle. So let us see now the case for a composite object. For that, I have taken a building block for a phospholipid bilayer, which we saw in a previous video. We call it composite because it is built together from various simple shapes. Remember, we had built this from a circle and two independent lines as tails. We have three ways to go about placing many copies of this object on a path. So I am going to duplicate, so we have three copies all together of this unit. And I will quickly write the basic operations we are going to do with each of them, and then give them different colors so that it's easy to follow. Here I write green, union. Here I write red, combine. Here I write yellow, group, convert to path. For the first composite structure, we will make a union by selecting the object and going to path, union. For the second, we will combine by selecting the object and taking Ctrl K. If we take Ctrl K to combine this object, the legs will pop out to view. I take Ctrl Z to reverse the action. We want to duplicate two times, then select one of the tails, send it below or behind, and then select the circle and go to Path, Difference. This way, we will have a tail we easily can oppose directly on the circle. Repeat this for the other side and oppose. To make sure no gap is between them, you need to zoom in manifold. So I am going to zoom in, make sure the two new tails are well opposed to the circle. Once you're done with this stage, you are ready to combine the individual objects. Select all the objects now and take Ctrl K to combine the objects into one. Any of these two objects can be spread along a path without the need for converting them first to a path. For the third one, we will take Ctrl G to group and then go to path, object to path, to convert the selection to a path. If we do not make a union of the object or take Ctrl K to combine or Ctrl G to group and then convert to path, we will have an error message when doing the next operations. Draw a path along which we want to spread the object. For here, I want to draw any fancy path using the pencil tool or the Bezier tool. So I'm going to choose the Bezier tool and draw a line. Then let us use a node tool to grab the line and pull it down to curve it. By the way, I have links in the description on how you can use the Bezier tool to do such drawings. I will adjust the length to squarely fit the number of objects that could get on the line and get back to you. For the next step, it is important the pattern is always on top of the page. Select each of the patterns and make sure they are on top by coming up here and selecting Raise Selection to Top. I will do this for the first one, do it for the second one, and finally for the third one. Now select one of the composite objects and then the path below it, then go to Extensions, Generate from Path, Pattern Along Path. Here under Copies of the Pattern, select Repeated. Under Deformation Type, select Snake. Select Duplicate the Pattern before Deformation and leave every other setting as it is, then Apply. I will go ahead and select the others and repeat the procedure. You can do this along if you have your own Inkscape open. It is fun and exciting, isn't it? I want to give you a note of caution here. When we talk about paths here, along which to place the patterns, we do not refer to simple shapes. So you will not, for instance, draw a circle and imagine the objects are going to be distributed along it in a repeated manner. One way will be to draw a circle using a path. We can do this for a circle by selecting the Bezier tool, which we learned before is used to draw line segments. Change the mode up here to create spiral path. By the way, I have a video in the description showing you how to optimally use the Bezier tool. Then click on the canvas. Pull the mouse to another place. Click and pull to the origin and click to close the circle. You can use this circular path to place patterns on it without first converting the object to path. Drawing such a circular path, however, needs practice. I will pull this circular path below and opt for a simpler solution for you. So alternatively, we can draw a circle using the ellipse tool and then convert it to path by selecting it and going to path, object to path. So select the ellipse tool and draw a circle and then go to path, object to path to convert it to a path. I have pre-calculated what kind of geometric properties of the circle we should have for us to have a good spread of the target object. So I'm going to give it a diameter of 29.651 millimeters, which should give me a circumference which divides the length of my target pattern object into a round number. If we draw a circle using the ellipse tool without converting it to path, we would get an error message when trying to do the operation. Now let us repeat the procedure above using the extension menu. Select one of the circular object path and then the path below it and go to Extensions, Generate from Path, Pattern along Path. Here under Copies of Pattern, select Repeated. Under Deformation Type, select Snake. Select Duplicate the pattern before deformation and leave every other setting as they are. Then select Apply. Repeat this for the other objects we had produced before. My aim of bringing the three methods is so that you get an expertise of the different methods and know which one to use if you have to do your own illustrations. For circular or ellipse path like this, the orientation of the object on the path will be different based on the path that is used. To round up, let us try to put one of the objects around the circular path we drew first using the Bezier tool. We will again select the pattern, make sure it is on top, and then select the circular path and use the extensions menu just as we have done for the others before. You see that the patterns face in a different direction. Now it is time to make an appraisal of all three different methods. We see similar results for the versions where we used group and combine. And for the case where we used union, we have a change in the line width. You could choose any of these methods as long as you attain a result. One good thing for all three methods is that you can do a global selection after accessing the nodes and then change the attributes on the fly. An important consideration is that if we drew a path whose length, or in this case circumference divided by the length of our pattern, does not give a round number, we will have overlapping patterns or patterns with a gap. If you find difficulties with gaps, please do leave a comment in the description and I am going to help you to define the geometric properties of your objects so you have a perfect spread along the path. I have shown you here how you can spread patterns on a predefined path using the extensions menu. As indicated before in the introduction to this part of the series on path effects, going by extension instead of the LPE will be the method of choice for some illustrations as your object keeps its attributes. In the next two videos, we are going to see applications of this by illustrating nature quality vesicles and the process of exocytosis respectively. Thank you for watching this video. Please do not forget to like and share. If you find what I'm doing useful, do consider subscribing and leaving your comments and requests below for more awesome tutorials. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you around in my next video.